Netflix is one of the biggest streaming platforms worldwide. But in India, it's not only bad, it sucks. With the exception of Sacred Games. But to be honest, it's been too long. There's nothing that Netflix has given us that is memorable. While platforms like Amazon Prime, Z5 and Hotstar are coming up with great series and movies and producing them with good actors and a high budget. Netflix, on the other hand, is constantly producing movies and series that are below par. So with that in mind, this is our video about the top 10 worst Netflix India movies. Before we start the video, this list contains movies that are produced by Netflix and were digitally released only on Netflix instead of theaters. Now that we have that cleared, let's get started. Number 10, Chopsticks. Now, Chopsticks is certainly not the worst movie out there. But would we recommend you spend 2 hours of your life watching this film? Certainly not. To completely sum up this film, it feels like Faltu ka time pass. The casting was good, like Abhay Deol, Vijay Raaz and Mithila Palkar were all good. But when you get down to it, the story was utter nonsense. We have this seedhi saadhi girl named Nirma Sahastrabuddhe whose car is stolen. Abhay Deol, who's a porn artist and loves to cook. And Vijay Raaz as a bhai who loves a bakri. Now all of this could have been a good nonsense film if it was meant to be a comedy movie. But instead, it was just in the middle. It was not serious nor funny enough. It was just a slice of life film that didn't feel like real life. And that is why it's making our list. Number 9, What Are the Odds? The most recent addition to the Netflix lot is What Are the Odds? Now by the trailer, it looks like an amazing mix of a coming-of-age movie and a trippy what-the-fuck-is-going-on kind of a movie. Because the trailer is a lot. And you want to watch a lot more of it, right? But when you start watching it, you notice that the aesthetic is right. Like the director Megha Ramaswamy fills the movie with the symmetric white shots with craziness all around. But deep down, you know she's really trying to hit the Wes Anderson whimsy but is not able to. The movie starts off as a good meet-cute where the two leads are forced to spend a day together and then crazy things happen. But the worst part is that the movie very inconveniently switches from the crazy narrative to the normal one. As if the director is just tired of whatever she's trying to make and abandons the crazy at really pivotal points. All in all, the movie is okay because of the leads, and I now know that Yashwini Damaya will make anything work for her. The only straggly end of this film, however, is the director who has the story and the whimsy in her mind but is somehow not able to show it to us. But A for effort, I guess. Number 8, Guilty. When Guilty was released approximately 2 months ago, it got very mixed reactions from both critics and the audience. Some loved it while the others hated it. Now that this film is in our list, you know where we stand with it. Making a movie about a sensitive matter like the Me Too moment is always going to be tricky. But when a guy like Karan Johar is producing it with a debutant director, there are things that are gonna go wrong. Like any other Karan Johar movie, the college life shown is just fucking unrealistic. All of the students are smoking joints and making rock music. And the girls are just trying to seduce this one hot guy in the college. I mean, there's a scene where one guy carries a girl on his shoulder inside a classroom while the class is going on. Bhai, dunya ke kaun se college mein aise hota hai yaar? Hame bhi admission dilao. And when it comes to the story of the film, it's just a cliched story in a mystery setting where the characters' motives don't make sense. The incoherent writing makes you never feel for any of the characters involved. And this movie came after movies like Pink and Section 375 that already covered the Me Too topic in a much more solid way instead of making it a college drama. And even with all of these mistakes, this was not the worst thing Netflix India did. Number 7, Brij Mohan Amar Rahe. This was the start of Netflix India turning into shit. Before this, Netflix India put out stuff like Love Per Square Foot and Lust Stories, which were at least watchable if not good. But this was the first film produced by Netflix India that was actually very bad. Brij Mohan Amar Rahe is a crime comedy, where a person who's fed up of his life decides to fake his death and start a new life. This is just a satire movie that is full of forced comedy where everything quirky is done just for the effect. Like saying Behenchod 5 times in a minute and then explaining the different connotations of Behenchod, Brij Mohan even gives us the stats of the percentage of women in India who have sex fully naked. Like anyone even asked for it. It never, even for 1 second, feels like the director wants to tell us an entertaining story. But instead, it feels like he just wants to put forward quirky, over-the-top, fake characters that we should think as cool people because they abuse, have sex and listen to 80s and 90s Bollywood songs. Number 6, Maska. A story about a Parsi boy who wants to be an actor instead of taking over the traditionally family-owned Parsi cafe in South Bombay. Now if you go and watch the trailer of the film, you will know the entire story of the film. Not because the trailer gives it away, but because the movie is just so predictable and so fucking bland. We have seen a premise like this over 100 times, and not only in films but also on television. A guy makes a mistake, he realizes his mistake, and then rectifies it in the climax. Now, Maska could have been a better movie if it made us feel for the right characters. But instead, the film focuses too much on a love story that ends up nowhere. And the pace of the film is also hella slow. Manisha Koirala and Javed Jafri bring a little bit of heart to the movie, but overall, it's a big pass. Number 5. Rajma Chawal. This is a story about a boy who has been moved forcefully to Purani Delhi by his father, played by Rishi Kapoor, and he hates it because it reminds him of his late mother. He barely has any kind of conversation with his father because there is definitely a disconnect, and he obviously has a difficult time settling in because Kabir is an angsty teen who somehow looks like he's in his late 20s. He's in a band and cannot be separated from his guitar. Nothing new here, guys, nothing new. But then his father, in order to connect with him, makes a fake Facebook account of a girl, catfishes his son in order to just talk to him, and then the girl whose photo is used in the account shows up. Now, although this whole Facebook and catfishing shit might sound new to you, but it doesn't feel like it's new. Like, you can't feel anything for anyone in the entire movie because you're just so busy dismissing everything. The story is bad, they got Delhi totally wrong, the kid is not interesting, the father and his friends trying to figure out Facebook is not interesting, the girl is not interesting, there is literally nothing that this movie gives you except for loss of time and a few brain cells. Number 4. House Arrest. Now, this was a movie that had a very interesting concept to start with. It's a story about a man who has voluntarily decided that he will spend the rest of his life inside his house and avoid all social interactions in the pursuit of peace. He gets food delivered to his house, works on his online business, and talks to his best friend on the phone. And that is all the contact he has with the outside world. Now, that's a good concept. But is it a good setting for a romantic comedy? No. The whole innovative premise gets old pretty quickly and the limitations of the concept come to light. Is concept pe short film ban sakti hai, 2 ghante ki movie nahi. And the makers did try to keep the story interesting with a mystery and a man taped and bubble wrapped inside a bag for several hours, which is odd because how did he not die of suffocation? But whatever, we are not talking about a great film here. We are talking about a Netflix rom-com with a quirky idea that loses its uniqueness very fast. In short, a very below average Netflix movie, as always. Number 3. Ghost Stories. Who doesn't know about the massive failure that was Ghost Stories? Following the somewhat successful Lust Stories, the four directors decided to band together again and make another anthology film called Ghost Stories. Four different ghost stories that are in no way, shape or form related to one another. And the trailer really looked promising. Plus, names like Anurag Kashyap, Dibakar Banerjee and Zoya Akhtar were enough to get us excited for the film. However, when it released, it was nothing but a big disappointment. None of the four stories give us anything to like about. All the directors try to scare us with their metaphorical thoughts about real horror, but none of them scared anyone. While the acting was subpar in every segment, let alone a proper spine-chilling story, Ghost Stories didn't even manage to give us a fucking jump scare. Number 2. Drive. We all know that Netflix didn't actually produce Drive, but Karan Johar did. But Netflix was dumb enough to take this movie and officially release it on their streaming platform. A movie that Karan Johar decided not to release in theatres. The same guy who produced Student of the Year 2 and released that in theatres was ashamed to release Drive in theatres. But then Netflix went to Karan Johar and said, "Maro mujhe, mujhe maro." I mean, anyone who has watched Drive for more than 10 minutes knows that it's a garbage film that is incomplete. And it's only suited for people who like TikTok. So why would educated people who pay for Netflix ever want to watch this hot mess of a film? Hell, even TikTok ke chutiye don't like this film. It's like Fast and Furious ka KRK version. And no matter how much I insult this film, I know it's going to be less. And whoever made the decision to release Drive on Netflix needs to get fired immediately. Number 1. Mrs. Serial Killer. Just imagine, you're one of the best streaming platforms all over the world. You come to India and you start producing movies. And then ek din tera dimag chutiya ban jata hai. And you decide to produce a movie that is directed by Shirish Kundar. I mean, come on Netflix, you can't let the guy who directed Joker direct another movie. Yaar, uski khud ki biwi Farah Khan doesn't produce his movies anymore, man. And then you hire him to direct a film named Mrs. Serial Killer, where the female lead obviously has the most important role. and then you go and cast Jacqueline Fernandez for that role where she has to act. See, if you want someone to act, you can hire any other actress. Who the hell hires Jacqueline Fernandez for an acting role? See, the premise of the film is not actually bad. A serial killer movie always is and could have been at least a little successful if Shirish Kundar did not direct this film. At times, the film feels like a parody of itself. And honestly, this film lacks any kind of thrill and the action is just comedy. Manoj Bajpayee does has his small moments of good acting, but he has less screen time. Here, who the hell gives Manoj Bajpayee a supporting role and Jacqueline the leading role? I swear, yeah, मुझे ऐसा कॉन्फिडेंस चाहिए जहाँ मैं इतनी बेकार मूवी डायरेक्ट करके नेटफ्लिक्स को चूतिया बनाऊँ. So this was our video about the top 10 worst movies made by Netflix India. Do let us know in the comments below, are there any other movies that we missed or are there any movies on this list that you like? Let us know. Also let us know what are the videos we should make next. Hope you're staying safe, guys. Like and share this video and subscribe to Brainwash for more videos like these.